Hello, I'm Chris Menard. Welcome to my channel. Feel free to subscribe. Microsoft Teams threw me a wrench. The meeting controls in our meetings, which I'm in a Teams meeting all the time, have changed. They've grouped some of the meeting controls. So it is January of 2023. This change happened right around the middle of the month. So let's go ahead and look at how the meeting controls used to be and how they are now. Also, my Microsoft Teams online training class is over 3 hours. There's a link down below where you can click on it to sign up for it. Let's dive into this video right now. So I'm already in a Teams meeting. The meeting controls are still up in the top right. That's the good news. Just in case you're wondering, I did this intentionally. I have a screenshot in my Teams meeting and I'm just moving it around to show you this. This is how they were before the second or third week in January. When you went to the word more, listed straight up and down were all the controls. Camera, mic, and share, they have not changed. If you look up in the top right, they're in the exact same place. But now the new controls, when I go hit more, we've got them into different groups. So let's take a look at this. Record and transcribe. Any of the groups that have an arrow to the right of them means they got more than one option. So I click here. There is my start recording and start transcription. Very popular. Meeting info and meeting notes, one item each. If I click on meeting info, nothing new here. It pulls up the meeting info. I can click on the link to share that link with someone else. Same thing with meeting notes, minor stuff, but they did change the order of these. No big deal there. There's the screenshot showing you meeting info and meeting notes. Notes was ahead of info. They moved those around. No big deal. Video effects. This is where your background settings are. So if I click this, I did happen to catch this. So there's none. Where you can add a new one, and there's the famous blur feature that people love. You do have filters down below now, and I'll do a separate video on that. Back to more. Here you go, language and speech. This is going to be turn on your live captions. I'm guessing they're going to add something in here because I just said a second ago, you see an arrow, there's going to be more than one item. So they could have made turn on live captions just something by itself. So I got a feeling something's coming soon to be added on here, but there's your live caption features. The one that has the most items is settings. When you go to settings, your device settings, that is your audio and your camera. So if you pop into a Teams meeting and you got multiple cameras, maybe you're on a laptop and have an external camera, that would be your device settings. Let me go ahead and pop it up here for you. That is down here at the bottom. Here is your audio device. Maybe you have multiple audio devices and it's picking up the wrong one. That is in here also. And soft focus and adjust brightness. That's also fairly new, but it was in the old one. Back to this settings. Let's go here again. Call health. That'll tell you how your bandwidth is doing on your call in case you've never been here. Rarely go there myself. Meeting options, major here. This is where you come in here and decide if you want someone to be a co-organizer. This is also where you decide who's going to bypass the lobby and whether you're going to have chat enabled or disabled. Still in the old one, but just I'm just letting you know it is in a different place. Here's a cool one. A lot of people don't know what mute notifications are. I'm going to tell you. Before I start a meeting that I know I'm going to present, and I'm on a Windows computer, I go to start, I type notifications, and I turn off all my notifications. So therefore, if I get an email, it doesn't pop up on my screen or anything like that. But your Teams notifications, you'll still get if you're in a meeting. So this mute notifications, that turns off all your little chats popping up in that feed or banner in the bottom right-hand corner of your screen. So make sure if you know you're going to present or if you're presenting and recording, you turn off mute notifications. So now I won't get any chat messages coming in here. Back to the screenshot. So I'm just letting you know, we had all these features just running up and down. Now they are in groups in the new teams. Couple other minor items. Let's see if I can jump here. This is how the controls used to look, again, over in the screenshot on the left. People and chat swap places. Minor, but I'm just letting you know that chat and people swap places. Also, a couple other ones. The word react was reactions. And inside of reactions, when you clicked here, the first icon that you had was raise hand. So now react is these icons, and raise hand is an icon simply by itself. So that was reactions. Rooms is still rooms, no big deal there. But also under more in the old one where your different views, we have our own icon for views now. So instead of it being under more, here are your views. Gallery, large gallery together mode, they're all still in there. In case you're wondering, when does large gallery click in? Got to have a Teams meeting. Got to have at least 10 people with their cameras on for large gallery to work. And then once you've got those 10, it can go up to 49 people with their camera on. You'll see them in a 7x7 grid. More than 49. So act like there's 7. And I'm running down here to the bottom and I got 80 people in my meeting. I would have an arrow to the right and then an arrow to the left to go and see more people in large gallery view. I appreciate your time. Have a great day. Thank you.